Only on 7, breaking her silence for the very first time. We thank you for joining us here at 6 tonight. I'm Dave Llewellyn.
And I'm Carolyn Clifford. Tonight, the newly appointed attorney for accused Oxford High School shooter Ethan Crumbley talking one-on-one with 7 Action News.
Crumbley is behind bars facing numerous charges, including terrorism and 4 counts of premeditated murder that could potentially lead to life in prison.
Well, tonight, his new attorney, Paulette Michelle Lofton, is telling us about her next steps in his criminal defense and how she plans to move forward ahead of Monday's hearing.
Even being charged with very, very serious crimes, people still have rights. As a defense attorney, it's not as though I'm defending his actions. I'm defending him to make sure that his rights are preserved.
Well, now we turn to 7 Action News reporter Simon Shaquette outside the Oakland County Jail for a closer look at additional resources being approved for Ethan's defense.
And whether or not his parents could play a role. Simon?
Attorney Paulette Michelle Lofton says she's already met with her client, 15-year-old Ethan Crumbley, several times. Ethan is here at the Oakland County Jail. However, those meetings took place over video. And while she can't discuss their conversations, she can say she's already asked for more resources, which were granted.
There's a lot to look at. I have not been provided with anything yet, but I know that that's forthcoming.
With thousands of pages of police reports, videos, search warrants, and other crucial evidence in the case of the deadly Oxford High School shooting to examine, court-appointed defense attorney Paulette Michelle Lofton says she's already begun the work of representing accused shooter 15-year-old Ethan Crumbley. After several meetings with him over video and regular communication with prosecutors, she tells us she's not planning to confer with legal counsel for his parents, who face charges of their own of involuntary manslaughter.
My focus is solely on Ethan and Ethan's case. I don't anticipate that the three of us would be working together since they're not charged together on the same case.
Next steps, she says, include waiting for the prosecutor to go through discovery to redact information not intended to be made public. From there, she says she'll be working with a court-approved co-counsel, assisting her to examine a massive amount of info as part of defense work. With 12 years of experience handling capital murder cases, she says she considered a lot of facts in agreeing to represent Crumbley, including how parts of the case have played out in the media.
Obviously, the media is involved. I thought that it was very important to make sure that Ethan's rights are protected. Even being charged with very, very serious crimes, people still have rights.
Looking ahead, she acknowledges the impact of this case and the unique circumstances.
With so much of this already shared publicly, what's the biggest challenge in representing him as a client?
I know there are so many emotions behind this case, as there should be. There are a number of details that haven't been presented and haven't been brought to light, and hopefully that will come in due time.
And as for her client, charged as an adult,
I have to make sure that my client understands every single piece of evidence that is going to be potentially against him. And that's my job. As a defense attorney, it's not as though I'm defending his actions. I'm defending him to make sure that his rights are preserved.
Lofton adds there could be more delays in court hearings simply based on the amount of evidence and the time that it'll take to go through all of it. From Pontiac, Simon Shaquette, 7 Action News.
All right, thank you so much, Simon.